Now, she asked Joseph to come to bed with her. This is this right here, this part of the story, this is where Satan will continue to try and hinder us from being all that God wants us to be. Everything that God wants us to be, everything that God wants us to do, that's when Satan will come in and he will try to stop everything. He will try to throw a monkey wrench in the game. Amen. See, now, here we go. What would you do? What would you do if a nice looking man or a nice looking woman asked you to go to bed with them? What would you do? would you resist? Or would you give in? You got to think about that, because this is a whole setup here. This is a trap for Joseph, but Joseph doesn't know that yet. Amen? Lord, have mercy. So all I can say for Joseph was that he was quick on his feet, because he told that chick, nah, I can't and I won't. And verse 8, Joseph refused her. He rejected her. He told her to step off and kick rocks. Go on about your business. Girl, you better talk to the hand, because you gets none. This is what he's telling her. And Joseph told that chick, not on duty. I will not give in to you. Not on duty. I'm in charge of this house. Your husband is my master. He put me in charge of everything. I'm not fooling with you. So Joseph said in verse 9, my master holds nothing from me except you, because you are his wife. He putting it to her. He is definitely putting it to her. He is shutting her down. Now, do you think that she gave up after that day? Do you think she just accepted that no and said, okay, he don't want me. He don't want to go to bed with me. All right, I'm going to leave him alone. Nah. This woman was persistent about getting this man. She spoke to him every day. She was provoking him. She's teasing him. She is just wearing these provocative clothes and trying to get his attention. She's trying to make this thing so hard for Joseph so he won't resist her. I mean, who do you think this is right now? Do you think this is really Potiphar's wife? Or do you think that Satan is using his wife to get to Joseph? Exactly. See, this is Satan. He's working his moves to get Joseph to fall into the trap. And right now, Joseph has dominion. Joseph has power. He has authority over this situation right now. See, if Joseph falls into the trap, then God will remove himself from Joseph. Because God, see, sin separates us from God. So as long as Joseph do what he's supposed to do, then God will be with him. And Satan knows that. Remember, Satan knows that. But look at what happens in chapter 39, verse 11. Joseph is in the house all by himself, doing his daily rounds, checking the perimeters of the house. He's checking the interior of the house. Everybody in the house is gone. They went to the mall. They went shopping. He's just there all by himself. Well, at least he thinks he's there all by himself. Then here we go. Bam! In verse 12, Potiphar's wife grabbed Joseph, grab his clothes, and she tells him, come to bed with me. So Joseph, he's trying to get away from this chick. He was like, you know, get off of me. I can't do this. This woman is crazy. You know, so he runs out of the house. And so while he's running, she grabs a hold of his clothes. She got his clothes in her hand. And this woman really doesn't know how to take no for an answer. Now, not only Joseph had to resist temptation of Potiphar's wife, but he also was being falsely accused of having an affair with Potiphar's wife. Yes, 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 yes. She set him up. He was set up. So when Joseph didn't give in to her, didn't give her any of his loving, she did like the okay moment. You know how females do, be like, okay. Okay. So in verse 14, she told a lie on Joseph. She made it look like Joseph had raped her. So now she's trying to taint his image. She's talking about she was screaming for help. No, you were screaming for him to come in bed with you. She's lying. This woman is lying. So Satan doesn't like being ignored. Satan doesn't like being rejected. He will go to extreme measures to get you to succumb to his plan. See, Satan knows that sin will separate you from God. Satan, it was setting the stage. He was premeditating on Joseph, and the wife was the actor in this script. See, this script was already set. See, Satan tried to put a twist on the script, but God was already in the midst, praise God. Now, the wife wants revenge. She wants payback because he told her no. He denied her. He rejected her. So she wants payback. And she wants to send a clear message to Joseph that you no longer have dominion. Come on. Hello. Hello. See, don't you know that Satan would try to put a cap on your life? He will restrain you from your purpose. He doesn't want you to have what God has for you. He doesn't want that to come to pass. See, Satan knows that what God is trying to do in your life. He knows that God is trying to bring Joseph into a new season and give him a new anointing. Hallelujah. See, you have to remember that Jesus also suffered. He suffered. He was tempted. He was slandered, he was persecuted, and he was in prison. Now, in chapter 39, verse 20, Joseph's master took him and put him in the jail, the place where all the king's prisoners were confined. And this is the worst jail, ladies and gentlemen. Now, the master believed in the accusation of the affair between his wife and Joseph. He actually believed that Joseph tried to have sex with his wife. But in verse 21, it says, God was still with Joseph. Through all of this, God is still with Joseph. Now, God will demonstrate his power over all impossibilities. Now, when you're being boxed in and when you're at the end of your rope, that's when you will find God. See, the Lord Jesus, he waited 4 days before he had risen Lazarus from the grave. See, God don't come exactly when we call him. He will make sure that thing is dead and stinking before he will show you and demonstrate to you that he is the resurrection and he is the life. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Now, the prison for Joseph is the waiting room. Nobody likes the waiting room. Okay? Now, being in these waiting rooms, they're challenging. They're difficult to cope with, and we just don't like waiting. Now, Joseph was also in the waiting room, and this seems not to be working out for him. He's sitting there having these dreams. He had those visions. He's like, how can I have these dreams and these visions, and I'm sitting here in prison? This doesn't look right. This doesn't feel right. This is not how this is supposed to be. This is not how my life's supposed to be. So sometimes we're in those same old prison walls. We're waiting and waiting and waiting, and it seems like nothing is happening month after month. But Joseph, he went from a favorite son to a slave in the foreign land. He went from being a slave in Potiphar's house to the overseer of Potiphar's house. And then he's in prison. Now, Joseph is in prison, and this is Joseph's second pit. Now, remember, his brothers threw him in the cistern at 17 years old, a pit, and now he's in a prison, which is another pit, which is another delay in Joseph's life. See, men will fail you, but God will be with you even in prison. When you are waiting for an answer from God, remember how to respond in the waiting room, during the waiting period, during those difficult times. Amen. See, at the end of Joseph's waiting period, he became the ruler over Egypt. Amen. The Lord in Pharaoh's house. See, in chapter 50, verse 20, Joseph says, you intended to harm me, but God intended it for to be good, to accomplish what is being done, to save many lives. This is what he's telling his brothers. Now, sisters and brothers, the dreams brought deliverance. And God sent him to Egypt so he could grow and so he could be mature. And God will purify you when he's sending you adversity. Amen. See, we find ourselves in a delayed life, finding ourselves in a pit, being misunderstood. See, adversity, sisters and brothers, it builds character. Amen. See, you do not have to remain a victim of your past, and you do not have to give up on your dreams. You don't have to give up on your visions. And no matter what, and no matter how your life started, it will get better. It will get better. It matters how it will finish. Amen. And also be careful who you share your dreams with, who you tell your dreams to. And sometimes you might share your dreams too soon because everybody's not going to be able to receive your dreams. They're not going to be able to receive your anointing. Amen. Sometimes you just tell things to the wrong folks. So this concludes our Bible study lesson. It was short and sweet. And I just want to remind everybody who's watching on tonight, You know, your delayed life does not mean it's a denial. It does not mean it's a rejection. God wants you to wait on him, but he wants you to act in faith while you're waiting. Amen. So tune in next time, next Thursday at 7 p.m. on our YouTube channel. And you can check us out at www.tbocc.net. And also check out our Facebook page, The Body of Christ Temple. Amen. Thank you and God bless.